In this video, we're going to discuss how to calculate days sales outstanding, which is also known as the average collection period, sometimes called days to collect account receivable. It's basically days sales outstanding is telling you how many days it takes for this company to collect an account receivable. Okay, so it makes a sale on credit, and then how many days does it take before it actually collects that sale and turns it into cash? Okay, so there are a couple different ways that you can go about calculating this. One is, if you already know the account receivable turnover ratio, which I'll show you how to calculate again in a minute, if you already know that, you can just take the number of days in the period. So let's say we're talking about a year, you would take 365 and just divide it by the accounts receivable turnover ratio, and that will give you days sales outstanding. Okay. But the other way to do it is you could say, okay, let's just take average net accounts receivable, and then we'll divide that by net credit sales, okay? And again, net sales is gross sales minus sales discounts, sales returns and allowances, that's net sales. But net credit sales, we also are subtracting out cash sales, okay? So we divide by net credit sales, then we take this whole amount, and then we multiply that by the number of days in the period. So if it was an annual basis, we looked at the annual net credit sales, then we would multiply by 365. So let's do an example. So Woofer, it's a company that makes mechanical dogs. So they have $20 million in net sales during 2021, okay? But only $15 million of those sales were made on credit. Okay, so that's the relevant amount. We don't care about total net sales. We just want the credit sales if we know that amount, okay? The net account receivable at the beginning of the year was $4 million, and the net account receivable at the end of the year was $2 million. So the average net account receivable would be $3 million. You see 4 plus 2 divided by 2, that's the average, so it's going to be $3 million, okay? So now that's the amount that we're going to want to use when I ask for average net accounts receivable. So let's do the one way to calculate this. Let's actually calculate the account receivable turnover ratio first, and then I'll show you the other way to do it too. So the account receivable turnover ratio is net credit sales divided by average net account receivable. Okay, so we have $15 million in net credit sales, and then we just calculated our average net account receivable is $3 million. Okay, so we have our receivables turnover ratio is 5. That means during the year, the company collects its receivables 5 times. All we do, once we know this, the receivables turnover ratio, we take that 5 and we take the 365, because we're talking about a year in this case, 365 divided by 5, that gives us 73. Okay, now that means it takes the company on average 73 days to collect its account receivables. So let me show you the other way to do it. If you didn't already know the account receivable turnover ratio, you could just take the average net accounts receivable, which again, we calculated that was 3 million, and then divide that by net credit sales, which was 15 million, that was just given, and then multiply that by the number of days in the period, which in this case, because we're talking about annual, is 365. So we got 3 million divided by 15 million, that's 0.2, okay, and then multiply it by 365, that also gives us 73. So even if you don't know the account receivable turnover ratio, you could calculate it in this manner directly, and you're going to get to the same answer either way. In each case, it's 73. So again, that means that it takes this company, Woofer, 73 days on average. When it makes a credit sale, it'll be 73 days before it collects that credit sale and actually receives the cash. Now, what do we do with this information? Well, once we know this information, we can compare it to other companies that are in the same industry and say, okay, if it takes us 73 days to collect, and we look at other companies, it's only taking them 60 or 55 days to collect. And we say, well, what is it that we're doing wrong here? What is it that's different about our business model? Is there a legitimate reason that is taking us so much longer than our competitors to actually turn this into cash, right? Because if a company isn't doing a good job managing its cash flow, remember, if you ever run out of cash, the company will go bankrupt. So, and we can also look at a trend over time within the same firm, just looking at Woofer and say, okay, has our day sales outstanding, has it been going down over time? Is it increasing over time and so forth, right? And so in this case, if it was going up over time, we would see that as a bad thing, right? Is that means it's, so let's say next period is 87 days and it's like, wow, it's taking longer and longer to collect these receivables. What's going on? And if we were to see that, if we were to see some kind of a trend where we say, hey, it's taking us longer and longer to collect these receivables, it could be a couple of reasons. It could be that maybe we started extending credit to people who don't have the best credit, and a lot, there's a higher percentage of them aren't paying and so forth, or it's taking them a longer time to pay. Or it could be that maybe we're, the economy is in a recession, or there's something, some problems that happen to our customers, that our existing customers just aren't able to pay, or it's taking them a lot longer. They're delaying payment because they're having financial problems. So in any case, this is just kind of like a warning sign to say, okay, we notice that there's a trend that's going in the bad direction. Can we take action to do something about it?